Oh boy, this is a Windows video and I keep messing up this fucking microphone position. Little bit of controversy or I want to debug a false accusation about Windows. Call it what you will. This is taking out from the party line of Linux fanboys. Windows have ads in the start menu, and even if you take them out, uninstall them, or take them out of the start menu, Windows will put them back in again. Let's look at my start menu. This is how it looks like. I don't see... Well, I have Solitaire in there. I like using that. Paint 3D. I don't have Candy Crush. I don't have Angry Birds. I don't have Skype. I don't think so anyway. I haven't customized this 100%, but I've taken out the most of it that I don't like. Yeah, no Angry Birds, no Skype, no Zoom. No Zoom, right? Nope, no Zoom. And I installed this last year, where is it here? November last year. I reinstalled it because I messed it up. I was testing a lot of things on, I always have a Windows VM. And I was testing a lot of things under Windows 10. And I did some things that made it really unreliable. So I had to reinstall it. But I have ran... I installed Windows 10 on my physical computer. I always have Windows and Linux on it. When it came out in 2015. And as far as I can remember, it has never, during an update, re-enabled or modified my start menu after I customized it. So Candy Crush didn't came back in here and stuff like that. I will say this, I can't remember the first couple of years of running Windows 10 because I was kind of dual booting a lot back then because I had some gaming problems with Windows 10 the first year or so. So I installed Windows 10, went back to Windows 8, installed Windows 10 again and went back to Windows 8 again for gaming purposes. So I can't, the longest I can remember, like when I customized my start menu and was like, okay, now I'm 100% on Windows 10, was around 2016, 17-ish. And for me, it has not re-injected ads or any of that nature into my start menu. And like you can see here, I run this. I have run this VM since November last year. Quite a lot of updates since then. And on my physical hardware, actually, the whole system right now is Windows 11, but that is actually, like, here's a little bit newsflash for you. The SSD that I'm using right now, I think it's from 2016. Like I said, that was when I committed to Windows 10. Was it longer before that? 2014, maybe? At least I have at least had three Windows versions on it. I had Windows 8, then I upgraded from Windows 8 to Windows 10. Ran Windows 10 for its entire lifetime on this SSD. Upgraded to Windows 11 on this SSD. I have a video about it somewhere on my channel, how old this SSD is. Windows have not done that to me. I've run Windows longer on the same SSD than I ran any Linux distribution. On the same SSD and you know, like I haven't run Ubuntu for 5, 6, 7 years non-stop or anything like that. I jump a lot on my Linux distributions. But yeah, this Windows install, that's the host system for this VM here, has been running, Windows has been running off the same SSD and no reinstalls. No reinstalls. And I think I installed Windows 8 on it the first time. Then I went up to Windows 10 when I really committed to Windows 10. And then I never reinstalled Windows 10 again and ran that until Windows 11 came out. And then I upgraded to Windows 11. No, sorry, upgraded from Windows 8 to 10, from 10 to 11, and never had a reinstall. And never had I had, as far as I remember, have had Windows reintroducing suggested applications, ads, or anything like that into my start menu or any other place. If I customize something under Windows, it stayed that way. I will suggest one thing though. Let's just take Windows 10 here. You can download some some scripts it, disable telemetry service registry and stuff like that. I have noticed one thing. People having the most problems with Windows, I keep saying Linux, is people that are using third-party scripts. You know, they are messing and downloading scripts from GitHub or GitLab or messing around in the registry to as close to 100% disable telemetry data collections and stuff like that. Those are the people I have noticed have had the most problem with Windows. Stability issues, Windows adding features in they took away and stuff like that. And I suspect it's because that Windows update noticed that there is something wrong with the registry or there's something wrong with some core components. And therefore, I'm speculating here. Therefore, I think Windows is like, oh, this is not matching what it should be matching with. Like, this registry database is not as it should be. Or these files have been modified and should not have been modified. So therefore, they delete them and reinstall them, basically. So that also means a lot of the things that you customize are getting overturned, basically. So they will reactivate them because they're basically resetting the database or resetting the configuration files. I suspect that could be it. That if you're using like these how to remove telemetry in Windows 10, 11 scripts and privacy scripts that you download from GitHub and GitLab and stuff like that, that Windows, when it's updating, it's like, oh, this is not a good match. You know, there's something wrong with these files and hackers and stuff like that. So just to be safe, Windows could then say, you know what, let's reinstall or reset those config files you have altered with your scripts and stuff like that. And that means that you're basically getting back to a factory reset. I think that could be a reason why, because like I said, when I talk to people that don't mess around with third-party scripts for Windows and are not, you know, hacking Windows, they seem to have a better experience with Windows. Where the people that are hacking Windows and make Windows do things it was not built to do, you know, taking shit out of it that it should not be taking out of Windows, they seem in general to have a bad experience with Windows. So could that be why some people say that, oh, after a certain updates, you know, my menu bar is basically reset to default, factory defaults? And then we are not talking about should Windows allow you to do this and just say, oh, you didn't done this, so therefore not mess around with it. That's a totally different debate. I'm just trying to explain why it is and explain my anecdotal evidence and my own observations with Windows. I'm just not seeing what most Linux users are telling me I should see. I wish it was true because it will give us ammunition to bash Windows. But yeah, it's just not true, man. Anyway, I'll see you all later. Bye-bye.